Oh, man. Thank you so much, Leanne. And well done again to all of our winners, especially the person who took home that 3 million rand home, or could we call it an investment. Absolutely amazing. We'll continue to connect with Part of Flair. But let's continue now with the narrative that has unfolded over 30 matches that have been scintillating. We are only 2 games away from crowning the very first ever Mzansi Super League champion, with the Cape Town Blitz already securing a place in Sunday's final, a home final for them now. Their opponent will be decided tonight as the Josie Stars hosts the resurgent Paarl Rocks in the playoff ahead of this weekend's action-packed schedule. Mzansi Super League commentators Monty Zondeki and Alistair Campbell are here to share their final predictions and I think a summation of what has been an awesome tournament. Gents, welcome to our little slice of crazy here. Now you can see how we live in the early mornings. But I've got to say to both of you, it's been an absolute pleasure. As someone who's fairly new to the cricket game, to work with you guys has been absolutely fantastic. So thank you so much. We've learned a huge amount. Monty, I'm going to start with you, bud. Quite a campaign, bro. Quite a campaign. How do you put it all into perspective? Before we get into the teams playing tonight, what's your experience of the tournament been like?
I've thoroughly enjoyed it. I haven't travelled quite as much as Alistair, as I was saying earlier, but it's been great. It's a new experience, and obviously it's not very often you get the South African players themselves, the international players, that is playing against each other. Yeah. They're not available very often, so it's been nice, and then you get some new flavour with international players. So it's been great. It's been a great tournament, and it's been a good advertisement of our game as well.
Exactly that, of new players, of old players, playing players into form, and there have been competitive performances. Oh, and then there were 3. Soon there will be 2. Are these the 2 playoff teams that you expected that should be there, do you think?
Yeah, I think so. Definitely, definitely Josie Stars, definitely, yeah. Cape Town. I think they look after themselves. Paarl Rocks have come from behind. They lost their first 2 games and then got their Proteas back. And, you know, they fought hard and I think they deserve their place. The team for me that I think will be most disappointed are probably the Durban Heat. When you look at them on paper and you look at all their combinations, they should have done a lot better. But that's one of those things in the world of T20 cricket sometimes. I mean, you look in the IPL, the Delhi Daredevils. I mean, I don't think they've even got into a final yet. And they keep
global
buying big
superstars.
Players and they just cannot gel. Cannot get
together. AB and Virat Kohli.
Bangalore as well.
Bangalore especially. Yeah. But AB, they gel at some point and you would think they'll always be in the final, but they're not. So it's nice that you never know who's really going to win, to be quite honest. That's a nice thing about T20.
So what does Faf have to do to beat the Stars at home at the Wanderers, probably our biggest scoring ground in the country?
Yeah, you expecting a very high scoring game because of the conditions. They are very good for batting.
And the Stars can bat.
Well, they won the last time they were there, the Paarl Rocks, so they'll be high in confidence of beating the Stars there. They've got a very good batting lineup. I mean, most teams do have a really strong batting lineup. I think the difference between the 2 teams for me, I would say that I like the Paarl Rocks bowling attack. They've got a lot of variety. They've got a good balance to their side. The Stars, obviously, the Georgia Stars do have Kagiso Rabada, who's obviously the big star, the big strike bowler. So, but I do like the variety of the Paarl Rocks. So Faf, I think, has to get their bowlers. Because they do have an explosive batting lineup, the Georgia Stars. So
you might open with the slows again, just to mix it up. Mm-hmm. You know, we've spoken about so many of the marquee players, the big names coming back in the protest. Great to see them getting kind of geared up and sharpening that sword ahead of the next round of international fixtures. But the youngsters coming through, the Ryan Rickletons, the Nokias, how impressive has this tournament been from that perspective of unearthing these? So we didn't know who any of these guys were before this.
Yeah, and you live here, and I've
come here. Exactly, bro.
I know who all the Proteas are, obviously, so that was easy. And then, you know, commentating on that first game, I'm like leaning over, who's this guy? Who's this guy? You know, you do a bit of homework, but suddenly all these guys, and it's, all these youngsters. But I tell you what, not only the youngsters, what about, Graham Thompson? I've never heard of him, 31, 32 years of age, probably thought he'd never get on TV again, you know, playing in the lower levels. And Nono Pongolo, I mean, he was supposed to be commentating with us.
6 for 20.
It's not only yes. The guys that are on the radar, the youngsters that are on the radar, Unric Nokia, you know, obviously he hurt his leg, but I think there are a few young South Africans there that are waiting with bated breath for that IPL auction on the 18th, because there's a few little murmurings that maybe the IPL will be in South Africa and because of elections in India. So if that's bubbling underneath, there's a lot of the franchises there might go for South African-centric players.
Cha-ching, we've seen Pakistan really embracing
there's a few
us
guys
as well.
So, yeah, from the perspective of depth, you know, I asked a few of the overseas players, you know, what do they think? And I think insofar as standards are concerned, this is up there as one of the best tournaments in the world. South African domestic cricket is really strong. So from that perspective, and all it needed was, you know, maybe a few more marquee players, but it sort of came onto the scene so late that, you know, there was not a chance to really nail down some of the big players. But I think with preparation, I'm knowing full well that you've got a year to prepare for the next tournament, that you'll be able to really get some innovative things going and some better players next time.
I'm going to miss you guys. I'm going to miss you, man. Enjoy the weekend. You guys have done a sterling job. Now it's up to the teams, of course, tonight at the Wanderers. Paul Rocks taking on the home side, the Jersey Stars, to decide who will meet the Cape Town Blitz in that final.